Good afternoon, Heita Hola, and welcome to Soweto Afri Live Stream. My name is Lauren Mesh, and right here with me, I've got Mr. Bra Wiseman. Hello, Bra Wiseman.
Hello, Mesh.
How are you?
I'm together, thanks. And how are
I'm
you?
I'm good, thanks. Please tell us a bit about yourself. Who is Bra Wiseman?
Jesus. Where do I start? Bra Wise is an old young man. I've been around for quite some time. Born in KZN many, many years ago. Studied there in Escort. Mm-hmm. That's where I did my primary education, higher primary education, my high school education. And thereafter, I went to the Eastern Cape to do my junior degree at Fort Hare University. Okay. Came to Johannesburg, worked for Eskom as a marketing manager, did my honors with RAU, which is now UJ, University of Johannesburg. Mm-hmm. I then worked for Eskom.
Okay.
Worked for Eskom and then worked for the SABC.
Okay.
Also doing marketing. I started the marketing department as well for TV licenses.
Wow.
And then I did my honors. I did my certificate in theology, diploma in theology, bachelor of ministry, postgraduate diploma in marketing management with VITS. So I've been around. I've done a lot of things. I've worked for a number of companies, mm-hmm. corporates. And then I decided to venture and get into business.
Well, I can imagine. I mean, you've got quite an experience, especially in the marketing field.
Yes.
So, but then why helicopters? What made you choose that?
The reason why I started helicopters, I was here at Vilakazi Street many, many years ago, and I was mm-hmm. looking at the tourists that are coming to Mandela House. And I realized that these tourists, you know, they come from different countries to see Mandela House or to see South Africa, and they create a picture of Mandela House in their minds. Some of them would say probably Mandela House is a 7-story house or 6-bedroomed house and so on. But when they get here, it's only a 3-roomed house. And then what happens after that? Because they are here.
But nothing else more
exactly.
to do.
They go down Vilakazi Street, up Vilakazi Street, but they haven't seen the whole of Soweto. So that's where Fly Say Was comes in. We then grant them an opportunity. We fly them around Soweto. Around Soweto, around Joburg, around okay. Midrand. You can fly them as far as the Kruger National Park.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
that's
or
nice.
Victoria Falls, yes.
Okay.
Or anywhere where they want to fly to.
Oh, okay. Mm. And it must be a beautiful view to actually view the land from
it's,
from
it's
up there.
Very interesting. It's very
I can imagine.
Yeah.
Okay.
Know, to see Soweto from above. But you can still recognize Orlando Stadium, FNB Stadium.
Like Oconium, the iconic places that we
right.
have.
Yeah.
Wow, that's beautiful. Mm. So I gather you're a type of person that likes to be on the air, that
yeah.
likes to fly. Hence, today you are the person to bring us the Soweto live stream.
Afri Live Stream, yes.
Yes. So tell us more about that.
Yeah. Soweto Afri Live Stream is like your television channel on your hand.
Wow, that's nice.
You know, what is interesting, you know, when these tourists come here to South Africa, we can shoot them, after live stream them.
It's like exactly what we're doing now, streaming live.
Right.
So
when they come from Japan, when they're here at Mandela House, we can give them a link and then they can send that link to their relatives back in Japan or respective
oh,
countries.
Okay.
And then they can be able to see what is happening in South Africa. What are they doing in South Africa at that point
in Soweto,
in Soweto.
Nice.
To prove that when they are here, they are not mingling with lions or baboons or zebras or rhinos on the street, but they are mingling with people, as
okay.
you can hear the sound.
Yeah, with the African dancers outside, which is quite beautiful.
That's right.
So basically what you're saying is that with the Soweto Afri Stream, mm-hmm. is it Afri Live Stream?
Afri Live Stream,
basically,
sorry.
it's global. So
it's global.
With that link, real time, people can see what we're doing, they can hear what we're doing, have that experience as well.
At that time, at that point in time, in all the corners of the world.
Wow. Mm. That's quite huge, eh?
It's more than huge.
Okay. So why chose to do it here in Vilakazi, besides the fact that your office is based here?
Sorry, for the mere fact that, you know, Vilakazi Street is one of the iconic streets in South Africa.
Okay.
Because we've got two winners of, what did they win, Mandela?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Two winners, Mandela, as well as Bishop Tutu.
Yes.
Yeah. So let us go outside. I'll show you what's happening outside.
Ayo ya mala ya mala ayo 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 ayo
Watching now are the African dancers. They usually are here, I think every day. You can find the Zulu dancers, the Tswana dancers. What you just saw now was the Tswana music dance. They're actually showcasing the tradition. So it's all about preserving our culture and our tradition, about who we are. And right here I have Mr. Tumelo Khumalo. I found him chilling here next door, so I want him to tell us why he chose to come in here to do business here.
Oh, well, you know, next door is one of those places where people, whenever they come around, you find that it's people that know each other, they grew up with each other, they're getting older now. This is a chance for them to escape from the rigors of family life and just to unwind. But you know, much as the food is nice, there are many other outlets here that serve food and stuff, but I just come here for the acha. It's a very nice premium brand of acha, which you rarely ever find around the country. And I fell in love with it, and it keeps me coming here. More so, it's also a place where I can come and see my friends.
Seriously, you say the acha. So this place makes magnificent acha, or what's about this acha?
I don't know who makes it. It's called Noni Acha. It's a premium brand of acha. It's not your regular acha that you like.
Okay.
But you know the thing with acha is that you can eat it with anything. Mm. But if you get it right and you get the taste that you want, you know, you'll keep coming back to where you get it.
About your African and handmade stuff that you are selling here at the store?
The name of the store is Ndiza Craft Market.
Okay.
I'm selling curio and designer clothes.
Curio, what's curio?
Curio is things that are made for art.
Oh, okay. Mm. All right. And then what kind of things are we talking about here? I see you've got a beautiful dress, like for instance, the dress that you're wearing.
We're talking about jewelry, we're talking about ornaments.
Okay.
And we're talking about clothes.
Oh, okay. Mm. All right. Can you maybe also tell them about where this stuff is being made? I just wanted you to hold this one. I just quickly want to get the bag. It's very nice. I love it. This is so nice. Eh?
Yeah. The bag is made out of blinds.
It's like that wooden stuff that you make blinds with.
These are blinds, you know, the ones we close the windows with. Yeah, and it's 100% handmade.
I love the party Okay, so you make this or you train or?
You see these ones, there is this guy who's working with us.
Okay.
He's supplying us with
these
things.
All right.
Yeah.
They're very nice, eh?
We also make the placemat out of this.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's wonderful stuff that you make, eh?
Yes.
And how's business? Are people buying a lot?
Yes, people are buying because they're looking for different stuffs. So the more different we are, the more the buy.
But you're doing a very wonderful job.
Thank you very much.
I'd love to see you stay here and grow the business. I actually do beads as well. I used to train, so I used to train kids. Mm. So I love your work because I know how much effort and time it takes to make this.
Yeah.
Beautiful work that you've done. All right,
thank you very much.
We'll see you again soon. Thank you so much for your time.
Okay. Fill my heart with song and let me sing. Let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for. I worship and adore.
How are you?
Good, and you?
I'm good, thanks.
Right.
What's your name?
Marianne.
Marianne.
Yes.
Marianne, you said you speak Swahili.
Yes, I do.
Oh, okay. You from? Where are you from?
From Kenya.
From Kenya. Wow, wonderful. What inspired you to make such beautiful work that you do?
Okay. I love crafts.
Okay.
I love African crafts. So, yeah, that's why I'm doing this.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, would you agree with me? I don't know if you can move here. That this was inspired by the Madiba shirt.
Yes.
It's very beautiful, made. Is this handmade?
Yeah, it's handmade.
Okay,
it's
who makes this?
Woven.
It's what you call it?
It's hard woven.
Okay.
Yes.
And then who makes this?
My brothers are doing this.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And how? Which ones are the people buying the most? Because I know the I would assume the Mandela ones will be the ones that sell the most.
They do sell the most.
Okay.
But there are some people who don't want the figure, but they want the Mandela shirt.
Okay.
But not with the picture.
Oh, okay.
But
like, for instance, when you have the lion, which is
yeah.
Cool. Okay.
Yes.
True lion that you have there. Okay, I see you've got beautiful hats as well. Do you also make these hats? Or
No, these ones I get from someone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And the mats? Are these mats?
The mats I make.
Oh, you make these yourself?
Yes.
Okay. So when you say you make just sewing, or you also make fabric? Because I know, like, from Kenya.
And then I make the table mat themselves.
Oh, okay.
But I buy the fabric.
Oh, okay, that's beautiful. And how is it having business here in Vilakazi Street? Because it's a buzzing street, it's very busy.
Yes, there's people all the time, but you know business. You get to there, tomorrow you don't, but yeah, it's good.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Now, I love what you do, because you get to have a variety of the artwork. Oh, yeah, and these things, I love them so much. I actually used to make these.
Those are from Kenya?
Yes, a brother from Kenya taught me to make these ages ago.
Wow.
And we used to have like nice photo frames, but I love these ones.
Those are beautiful.
Do you make these ones?
No, I don't. I'm getting them from Kenya.
Because it would be interesting to know what story you're telling when you make these things, you know, because I also would have mine that I've made.
Yeah.
It's to say something about being at home.
Yeah, these are African hats, you can see.
Yes.
These are just a replica of the African hats. Those are the Maasai's.
The Maasai?
Maasai. They're actually the tallest guys in Africa, I think.
Okay. Yes. Wow, this is beautiful, hey? So not only are you just selling art, but it's African art,
yes,
that is teaching about Africa and our origin. And what is this? Is this like
those
a bookmark?
Bookmark? Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wow, these are beautiful.
These are nice.
These are so beautiful. And what material is used
leather.
Here? It's leather.
Yes.
Oh, okay. It's very nice, a nice type of leather. I've never seen anything like that before. And what culture is that with these ones? Would you say it's Kenya or just
specific,
African?
Just something African, yes.
I love these ones.
What is this wood? Rosewood.
From Rosewood?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wow, it's beautiful. So where do you get the rosewood? Do you bring it all the way from Kenya?
This is a mix of everything from everywhere. Like this one, they're from Maputo. They're from Mozambique.
Oh, okay.
So there are guys from Mozambique who supply them. That's where I get them from.
Oh, okay. And then they are the guys that make this.
Yeah.
I'd love to learn how to make this.
Not
then
really
I'll make statues of myself.
Not too easy, though.
I can tell. Maybe it doesn't look easy at all.
Yeah.
But this is wonderful stuff that you make. Oh, look at this. House in Soweto. Actually, I could put it right there and it looks like one of those houses.
True that.
Wow. Yeah,
they're just a replica of the house in Soweto. They call them matchbox houses.
Matchbox houses.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, so you can't open it. It's just closed off like
just
that.
Closed off, yeah.
But wow, this is so beautiful. This is like a true reflection of what Soweto is. Wow. I wonder if I could have something like that and maybe have it like a money box. Could you make me something like that? I know my kids would love that. And you put your money into your house in Soweto.
Yeah.
And they'll go look at the house in Soweto, but your money is actually in that house in Soweto. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
These are coasters.
Coasters?
Yeah.
Okay.
For cups and glasses.
Okay, then how many would you find in there? I'll assume four.
Six.
Oh, six?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
They have the big five and then African top.
Oh, nice. So you get the mixed ones?
Yeah.
This is so beautiful. Okay, what do you call this in Swahili?
What is this in Swahili?
I'll try. I think in Xhosa it's or something like that. I'm not getting the pronunciation right, but something like that.
I don't know the specific word in Swahili, but it's just a smoking pot.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So culturally, do also old women smoke this culturally?
Yes,
like
they do.
Oh, okay.
They do, yes.
It's interesting to know. Wow. You guys make beautiful stuff, eh?
Thank you. Yeah.
what are you guys doing here?
I'm actually showing him around because he's originally from the Netherlands. So yeah, I'm being a good friend and giving him some of the South African vibes and you know, just to for him to see how welcoming we are actually in this country and the whole perception of the world, Soweto being so violent and all of that, you know, because I just want him to actually see hand in hand how people live on a daily basis in these streets. And he's, I don't know, he can
and
speak for himself.
Sorry? Exactly what she's saying? Is that
yes.
What you're
saying? I really like it. Before, when I was planning my trip, everybody said, ah, you shouldn't go to Johannesburg. Maybe one day for the apartheid museum, but it's way too dangerous. And now, and then when I was on my trip, more and more people said, ah, maybe you should go. So now I'm here for 4 days, and it's my first day.
Only four days. Have an extended stay?
Yeah, maybe,
no,
maybe.
He's in South Africa for a long time.
Yes.
Johannesburg, it's just...
Not
how
4 days.
Do you guys know each other? How
we actually met yesterday.
Yes.
In the bar.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, and I was like...
in Mabone. I was actually there yesterday.
Yeah, and he was talking about taking a tour bus, and I was like, no, you have to meet a local.
Okay.
I'll take you there. Let's
so
just go
there,
for
the
it.
Are you there, the backpackers?
Yes,
the
curiosity.
I was going to ask, where are you staying? So you're not going to be staying any night in Soweto?
Sorry?
You won't be staying one night in Soweto?
I don't think so. Not okay. Planning it.
In future you will. I'll
yes.
convince him.
So this is your second day? Or?
I arrived last day. Yesterday.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Oh, so you're still here for a couple of
yes, till Monday.
Days. Okay.
Yeah,
so
South Africa
till end of June.
Oh, okay. All right. I wish I'd drink up because I'm always in Mabone. I was there yesterday.
I live there.
So. Where exactly?
What's this? I just moved this month, so it's Albertina.
Oh,
Albertina Road.
But would you say the vibe that you get in Maboneng is exactly what you get here in Vilakazi?
It's very different. Every place has a different atmosphere to offer.
Okay.
But just to experience everything, go to every single place. It has something different to offer.
Okay.
You know, because majority of the people there, it's still like tourists.
Very urban, yes.
Situation, but when you come here, you kind of have that warm feeling, you know,
and experience of people as well.
Yeah, you kind of feel at home as well.
Okay,
you know.
Have you tried any food here?
Not yet. I'm hungry.
Don't lie.
But not,
yeah.
not
he
here
tried,
today.
No. I mean here in Soweto. Here.
It's not Soweto, oh. not yet. But I did in Cape Town. The bunny other stuff.
Bunny porta.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Bunny
a lot of bones though, but. It was
oh,
really
good. The buzzer.
The pep, I did like the pep.
Oh, you like the pep?
Yeah.
You know there's a song, you put your fingers in my pep.
Oh!
Put your finger in my business.
Yeah.
You know that song?
No, I don't know that
But
song.
We're going to go as well to Chafbozi for
some,
you know, dry meat, some pep. Have a chilled vibe. Because even the music there, it's quite nice.
Yes,
and,
it is very nice.
Yeah.
You are going to enjoy it. Okay.
Nice. Really
lucky. Okay, so we'll see you soon.
Right, thank you.
Okay, so now see, no, Putin Tlandla outside his store, which is also in Vilakazi Street. You know, these stores from far, it looks like they're the same, but when you come closer, you actually see that it's different. So, Putin Tlandla, tell us about store circle. What do you sell?
I sell beadwork.
Okay.
As you can see, I sell wooden craft.
These are beautiful fabrics that you have. Are these local?
Yep, they are also local.
Is it? Are they South African?
Yep.
Wow, this is beautiful. And you also sell these one, like these fabrics as well,
yes.
Differently from the ones that have made
yes.
stuff.
Yes.
Wow.
Nice.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.
You give us a variety of different stuff to buy, to purchase, which actually represent us, Soweto, and South Africa as a whole, which is very nice, which is beautiful.
Oh,
House Museum. I've got Sis Jane here. You can see the background is actually the most busiest place right here in Vilakazi. So our Jane will tell us a bit about her work and her involvement at the museum.
Mm-hmm. Okay, my name is Jane. I work here as a site guide. So we tell people the history of Mandela. Behind us, this is the house where Papa Mandela used to live 15 years before he went to prison.
Okay, and what do people come here to see inside the museum?
They come here to learn the history of Papa Mandela and to see where he used to live. And inside we have important things like there's a tree inside. It was planted by him, Mandela. Under the tree they bury the umbilical cords of the children.
Oh, okay.
So it's an African tradition to connect them with the soil, to the ancestors, because when we die we go back to the soil.
Okay. So I see that this is the most busiest place in Vilakazi. Roughly plus minus how many people visit this place in a day?
Weekends it's crazy sometimes, plus minus 400.
Is it?
Weekdays,
I mean,
maybe
it's the 400 right now.
Yeah,
maybe
yeah.
Even 1,000.
We have some people here from South Africa. They're from Four Ways, 92.
Okay.
It's a big group.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Ed, this place being a museum,
mm-hmm.
do they also have some things that they can buy and take home with?
Yes, we have souvenirs inside,
okay.
T-shirts written Madiba House,
okay.
caps also written Mandela House,
okay.
and also books for those who like reading.
Okay,
yeah.
Just one more last question. Do you maybe teach them to do the Madiba dance?
Because all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfection. Give your all to me, I give my all to you. In my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning.
Okay guys, this is one of the oldest tour operator guy I know, ever since I was still in high school. And Tata Jim.
Hello. Legai.
Good day.
Yeah.
I thought I should talk to you. Lovely seeing you here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're basically streaming live on Soweto Afri Live Stream.
Yeah.
And we're just talking about Vilakazi and experience. And I thought because when you are going to as the oldest person that we know,
yeah.
as a top operator,
yeah.
that you love this place.
Yeah.
Maybe anything you want to say about Vilakazi? Sorry,
well,
to accept you
Vilakazi Street is one of the most famous streets that I've grown up moving around here. Even during the days of the uprising of 1976, we were marching heading to Orlando Stadium where we couldn't reach our destination. Why? Because we were fighting for change in terms of education. And that time I was 15 years of age. Today I'm 58 and I never knew that I'll be the one that tells the stories or telling the stories of the past era. But today we are enjoying the fruits of our struggle from that time. Then today it's a very busy street whereby everybody wants to come and see Mandela's house and also the house of Archbishop Tutu, because those are some of our icons whom we grow up playing their part, fighting for the struggle in the country. So that's why we love this street so much. And then for now, we have thousands and thousands of tourists or millions of tourists coming to this street so that they can see what is happening around here into this famous street of Soweto, where we have two icons of South Africa, Mandela and Archbishop Desmond Tutu. And the last part of it, the cherry on top, 2 days after Mandela's release from prison, I managed to shake hands. With him, and I had to spend the whole week without washing my hand. I was excited.
Welcome to the Wine Bar. This is the Wine Bar in Soweto. So people travel all the way to come to Soweto to enjoy traditional food. So we have now a traditional tasting plate where I enjoy yomkhodu, mlekwa, and oxtail paired with many glasses of wine.
And then I see that you also have a beautiful place here. You have the cigar lounge. Tell us more about what happens in the cigar lounge.
A cigar lounge, after people, after having their meals, people go to a cigar lounge to relax. Some people come specifically for cigars to sit, relax, and have their conversation there.
Okay, so you would have something like your gentleman's club here?
Yes, we do. We like host it once after every 2 months.
Okay.
So we invite guests that enjoy wine, whiskey, and cigars.
Oh, okay, wow. That's very classy. Basically, this is the classiest place on Vilakazi. We call it the wild place. This is where you find your cougars and your expensive people that live an expensive lifestyle. Am I right?
No, welcome everyone. It's every.
Afri Live Stream, right here in Vilakazi Street.
Yeah, basically that was just a sneak preview of what you expect in Vilakazi. This was the official launch of the Soweto Afri Live Stream. We're expecting to see more of this activated. Is it right, Brawise?
No, more than right. I can tell you now, this is the end of the beginning. There are beginning things to come. So, you know, it's like you say, we're doing the creativity, we come to the end, and then we know where we are going to start.
Okay.
So it's the end of the beginning. The bigger things are going to come. Watch Afri Live Stream. It's going to rock the world, not even Soweto.
Yes, we already are rocking the world. I was hearing that we're having people watching us in Belgium and Denmark and other places.
Saudi Arabia.
So, which is quite amazing.
Yeah.
All right, I look forward to having more and sharing with you guys more with regards to what's happening in the township and other businesses, and also in the CBD, because I think you're launching Soweto and Johannesburg, right?
Yes.
Yeah,
right.
Great stuff. So guys, please do spread the word, spread the link, and make sure that you also watch and you don't want to miss out.
Yeah.